when you look back with the advantage of hindsight in the 21st century, and recall that many of our forebears would have come here secretly, silently, no music, to offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass in honour of the Assumption of Our Blessed Lady. Because despite the fact that the feast was declared a dogma of the Catholic faith by Pope Pius XII in 1950, it was believed from the earliest of time. It's a very ancient feast. And in the breviary for today, and perhaps also in part of the Divine Office, the Church applies to Our Lady words that were first spoken of Judith in the Old Testament, that forerunner of feminism who decapitated Holofernes in his bed. Now you're supposed to smile at that. Surely, you know. What did they say? To Gloria Jerusalem, you are the glory of Jerusalem. To Laetitia Israel, you are the joy of Israel. To honor Fortigantia, you are the honor, Populi Nostri, of our people. We certainly can say the same thing about Our Blessed Lady. For if there was one great truth concerning Catholicism in its various forms throughout the centuries in Ireland, we were devoted to the Mass, and we were devoted to Our Blessed Lady. Both, it seems, they go inevitably together. And why not? He who honours the Mother in no way dishonours the Son. And in sacred scripture, especially in the Old Testament, the Church has taken some of the imagery, especially the imagery in relation to trees, whether it be the cypress tree or the olive tree. The Church has applied those images also to Our Blessed Lady. I'm not going to go into any great detail to explain why, but the cedar tree, simply because of its loftiness, its altitude, its height. Okay, there were no giant redwoods in Palestine, but the cedar tree was considered a tree that really bespoke exaltation. And that's what the Feast of the Assumption is all about. The exaltation of Our Blessed Lady. That's why in the litanies we simply refer to her as the Queen of Prophets, because she did prophesy, "Behold, all generations shall call me blessed," down to this very day. Queen of Patriarchs, yes, indeed. Queen of Confessors, yes. Queen of Martyrs, don't we always associate the rose with Our Blessed Lady, the colour of blood? Not a physical martyrdom, surely, no. But, as many theologians could say, she suffered a spiritual martyrdom with her Son, thereby, though not defined, earning her the title of co-redemptrix with Christ. So Our Blessed Lady is intimately associated with the life of Christ, and therefore with the Holy Mass itself. That's why, at least, we Irish never separated the two, perhaps like many persecuted Catholics down through the centuries. But all Our Blessed Lady's singular privileges come from one particular source: that she was chosen to be and accepted to be the Mother of God. flesh of our Blessed Lady and the flesh of Jesus Christ are the same. And because of our divine maternity, we realize that she was without sin, no original sin. Tota pulcher es Maria. Thou art all beautiful, O Mary. Et macula originalis non est in thee. And there is no stain of original sin in you. Therefore her body would never see corruption. It was totally fitting. And how she was assumed into heaven, who knows and who cares? We just know that in heaven there really is no body. No saint's body, except the body of our Blessed Lady and our Blessed Lord Himself. So on the Feast of the Assumption, our Blessed Lady was reunited in some way with her Divine Son. We will not be reunited with our bodies, glorified as they will be in the general resurrection of the dead, if you've been faithful to Christ, for we will not have that privilege until the end of time. Not so for our Blessed Lady. And if anyone really has summed up in a very pithy way the very essence of our Holy Mother, it surely was, I don't want to shock you now by quoting a Protestant, but it's not what is said, but it is rather what is said, not who says it. But it was the poet Wordsworth, who has the most magnificent poem on our Blessed Lady. It's in part two of his Ecclesiastical Sonnets, I think, where he refers to her, and we acknowledge it readily on this day, O woman of all women glorified, our tainted nature's solitary boast. And there you have the source of the great prerogative that was bestowed upon her on this day, the feast of the bodily assumption of our Blessed Lady into heaven. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, amen. Why, Paul, I've written out at all.